Alyssa Ford Morrell. I'm a master gardener with the Master Gardeners of Northern Virginia, here to talk about invasiveness, specifically one invasive plant, English ivy. English ivy is invasive in a couple ways. It's invasive in the way that most people think of invasiveness, which is a plant that just spreads too much in their garden and is difficult to control. But in fact, it's also invasive in the more technical way that we're talking about today, which was defined in 1999 when President Clinton signed Presidential Order 13112 that defined invasiveness as being an organism, plant or animal, that is able to escape cultivation, or in the case of an animal, being moved from its natural environment, and get into the wild, causing harm in the wild in one of three ways. One would be to the economy, two would be to human health, and three is to the environment. English ivy has been a problem in that third way, to the environment. English ivy was introduced to America in 1724. It's been used extensively. It has been a go-to ground cover in many, many situations. People think that ivy is a great control for erosion. In fact, it's really not that great because it has very shallow roots, which don't do a good job of holding a bank in place when there's a lot of water. But a lot of people have big banks of ivy that are rather daunting to know how to replace. I'm here where the homeowner has actually started a really good process to replace it. What they did was they cleared an area of English ivy and put in a replacement, a native replacement plant. And they've allowed that plant to spread for a while now. At this point, what they can now do is pull away more ivy, and this plant will spread more, and they can also take up bits of this plant and plant it in the larger area, so that over time, it's an efficient and cost-effective way of replacing English ivy. Ivy growing up a tree is the worst of the worst. For one thing, it's really bad for the tree. The ivy adds a lot of weight to the tree, particularly when there is any ice or rain. During winter, an ice storm could add enough weight to actually bring a tree that's struggling down. It also is bad for the tree because it interrupts its ability to photosynthesize and get the light that it needs. But it's also bad because the ivy reaches sexual maturity up high, and only when it climbs. Up high is when the leaves actually change shape and it sets berries. Those berries are then eaten by birds who fly away, poop them out into your yard and mine, and spread the ivy. So taking ivy off of a tree is one of the most important things that you can do. It's actually very easy to do. All that you need to do is have a good pair of clippers, and you go after the ivy, and you generally make two cuts, one lower, one higher. So there's a nice big gap. And if you do that on the tree all the way around, you know that you have interrupted the tree's ability to climb up high. And you can then pull the ivy away from the base. You don't need to worry about pulling the ivy up off the higher parts. It'll die. And in fact, don't try to pull it off because you could damage the bark up high by yanking on that ivy. I do want to let you know that every time I've done this, I have found when I come back that I've missed at least one of these little pieces of ivy and that there's still some living ivy up high. But when I know that, it's not so hard to find that one hiding little piece of ivy. English ivy has been popular in America for a really long time. Unfortunately, it really does not provide support to any American fauna. With the sole exception of mosquitoes, ticks and rats, which probably aren't the ones that really need our support. So fortunately, we have some great replacements that you can plant instead of English ivy. The first native plant that I want to talk about as a replacement for English ivy is Parthenocissus, golden ragwort. It's a wonderful plant. It's super easy to grow. If there's a problem to it, it's that it really spreads almost too easily. You may want to have boundaries to keep it in place. But it's a great plant because it takes sun, it takes shade, it takes wet, it takes dry. It has these really pretty purple backs to a lot of the leaves. When it sends up a sprout, it's currently March, and this will be in bloom, depending on the weather, within the next week or so. As it sends up these flower shoots, the leaves change. You can see this is kind of a feathery shape instead of the oval shape of the ground level leaves. And then it's going to make beautiful sunflower-like flowers of bright yellow, hence the name golden ragwort. Don't confuse this plant with the allergy-causing ragweed. Golden ragwort is pollinated by pollinators, so it's not sending the pollen out to make you react to it. But it's a really beautiful plant that I highly recommend for all sorts of settings.
Another great choice as a ground cover replacement for English ivy is the really beautiful Virginia creeper, which is wildly versatile. It can take sun or shade, it can take wet or dry, it can take clay or sand. The last plant we're recommending here for you to consider in replacing English ivy is wild strawberry. This sweet little native is a great performer that loves the sun and will give you the tastiest little fruit as a reward for growing it. Whichever plant you go for as you replace English ivy, I wish you good luck and happy gardening.